right, ladies and gentlemen, before I was so rudely interrupted with a commercial break, we're going to conduct this interview right now. And in just a couple of moments, I'm going to bring Big Daddy Cool Diesel and Razor Ramon right out here. But before I do, I'd like to just beg your indulgence for just a minute or so and tell you something that I've got on my mind. There's something I've been waiting to say for a long, long time. And when I'm through telling you, many of you are going to question my loyalty to the World Wrestling Federation. So let's clear that up right now.
What's he talking about? I have no idea.
I have no loyalty to the World Wrestling Federation. I've only got loyalty to good old JR. Let me tell you why. In 1993, I left a great job in Atlanta, Georgia. And I left the Atlanta Falcons of the National Football League to go to the recognized leader of sports entertainment, the WWF. And I came here to be the primary play-by-play man in the WWF. I don't think anybody here is going to disagree that I'm the best play-by-play man in the whole damn business.
What's he doing? I really don't know. This is
so I show up for work the first day at WrestleMania 9 in Las Vegas, Nevada, and they give me a sheet to wear. They said, oh, it's going to be a toga. You'll look good in a toga, JR. I leave the National Football League for a toga. It's crap. And then, ladies and gentlemen, I go to the first King of the Ring in Dayton, Ohio. And I guarantee you, you listen to that broadcast, I carried the broadcast from ringside. And then did you ever wonder where old JR went to? Why isn't JR doing play-by-play anymore? Let me tell you why. Because the egotistical owner of the World Wrestling Federation, and you know what I'm talking about Vince McMahon, couldn't stand the competition.
Why is he doing this? This is rather unfortunate.
So JR disappeared. And then on Super Bowl Sunday in 1994, I woke up with an affliction called Bell's palsy. And my entire left side of my face looked like I had a stroke. You think I like that? You think I like that my left eye doesn't open all the way because I got sick? Let me tell you how warm-hearted Mr. McMahon is. Mr. McMahon called me into his office on February the 11th, 1994, and he fired my ass. So I get back in my car, and I'm driving to my home in that overpriced hellhole, Connecticut, and I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to tell my wife and my two little girls that their daddy had just got fired. And so then, remember when McMahon got indicted? They needed somebody to come back and do Raw? They called OJR. And then they let me go again. So finally they called me back, hired me back for 50 cents on the dollar to come back and work in the front office. Do you think that all these guys leaving the WWF was an accident? Hell no, it's not. You think all these guys coming here was an accident? Absolutely not. I've been very busy. And right now, I want to bring back one of your favorites. He's the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
And Hershey Park Arena explodes. Here he comes. Oh, the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
Wait a minute. Wait. King, that's not the urge.
I think this,
How do you like that, WWF? How do you like Razor Ramon?
What is JR trying to do? Is he trying to embarrass the World Wrestling Federation?
Razor, how's it feel to be back in the WWF?
Oh yeah, man. Chico, take a look at the bad guy, man.
Wait a second, Simon!